events. Power Rangers Zeo Battle Racers. So yeah, instead of a straight up fighting game or action game, we get some racing. Why the hell not? Okay, so yeah, you can do like in the two-player multiplayer. It has a few options here, which is kind of nice. Nothing too extravagant, but you know, it kills some time. Definitely a bit more robust than what's being given to you in the one-player mode. Yeah, this hits different stages altogether. Yeah, each world might have like two or three tracks. Yeah. It uses mode sound effects and it looks like shit. Thankfully, the game doesn't start off too hard. Yeah, if you lock the computer once in the first few tracks, it's no big deal. Yeah, but don't get used to it because later on, yeah, it's totally rubber band AI where they will totally cheat your ass later into the game. And when you get in last place here, it's very hard to catch up. It doesn't matter how many times you blast your enemy. Yeah, if you fall down too far behind, there's really no way you can catch up because you only got a limited amount of power-ups and items you can use. You gotta memorize these courses, top and bottom. They're short at least, but... man, there can be a lot of turns that are very annoying to recover from. Like here, it's not too bad. Yeah, so basically just coming first and shit and it carries over to the net circuit. You know, nothing too fancy. Yeah, once they get a nice sizable lead, it's hard to catch up. Not to mention you slow to a crawl and once you hit an oil slick or the corners. Yet the enemy, look at that, they're smooth as silk. This game was so easy up to a point, but now it's getting tough as balls. Problem is I want to do some drifting, maybe I can take those corners better, but nope. That's the one thing they didn't include from Super Mario Kart here. The one thing they didn't rip off! Well, not to mention the awesome gameplay, the awesome track design, the great graphics, the excellent music. It's just basic racing. And yeah, you have the occasional gun that has limited ammo. Big deal. Here we got this nice theme here, some good music here and there. But the graphics look like shit. Hey, it's a little bit too blatant how much the actual racing tracks look like Super Mario Kart. Yep, and it looks like fucking Koopa Beach here. Like Koopa Beach, but really fucking terrible looking. Alright, so the whole split-screen thing was cool in Super Mario Kart. You know, they had clearly identified areas, you know, that are your speed zones where you could slick out. Unless you memorize these tracks top to bottom, it's hard to know what you're driving on, and it's just very confusing, especially when you're playing this for your first time. I don't know if the camera's just zoomed in too much, or it's just way too pixelated and they weren't able to figure out the mode 7 effects. But either way, it looks so bad. Yeah, there's no super effects ship being used here. But for 1996, you know, I expected it a little bit more than this. Oh yeah, what's worse is this is one of the final Power Rangers games released for Super Nintendo, so it's gonna be the most difficult to find, but it's also the shittiest. Battle Racers. It earns a 28 out of 100. The multiplayer can be fun for a few tries, but yeah. With these shitty graphics and this boring level design here, yeah, you're not gonna have too much to work with. And the one player mode, just forget about it. Unless you're a diehard Zio fan or whatever, this is definitely one to avoid. And the only reason it got released is because of the whole stupid Power Rangers license. This was just a bare bones racer and you take out the Power Rangers, no way this would get released. It's so fucking boring, typical racing and shit. Yeah, basically it's a poor man too, Mario Kart. Don't get this, it's awful. Yeah, instead of Power Rangers Zeal, they should call it Power Rangers fucking Zero. Well, it's that fucking bad. Okay, this is Arizonk World Champion over now. Ding, ding, ding.